Testing your soil for nutrients gives you valuable information about your soil, which you can use to optimize plant growth and grow some really nice, healthy plants in your garden. Now, we will be using the Soil Master soil testing kit, and I'll provide a link in the video description so that you can buy this product. This product is available very cheap on Amazon. And in this kit, you will find a lot of tubes which you will use to test your soil nutrients. And this kit also has a lot of these tablets that you will see shortly. And these tablets are basically some chemicals that let you test your soil and make sure that you have adequate nutrients in your soil. Now, why do you need to do a soil test? Well, plants need three things to survive. The first and the most important thing they need is water and sunlight. Without these two things, you really cannot grow plants. Now, the third thing that you need other than water and sunlight are nutrients. Now, you can add nutrients to your soil either by adding organic matter or by adding fertilizers, whether organic or inorganic, and that's what really causes your plants to grow well and produce a lot of fruits, vegetables, flowers, whatever you may want from the plant. So doing a soil test helps you make sure that your soil has adequate nutrients for the plants to grow and flourish. So having seen the kit, let's proceed to the tests. So the first step is to take a soil sample. Now it is recommended that you dig a little bit. If you find these little helpers in your soil, just make sure they are tossed away to some other part of the bed where they can be helpful, and then take a handful of soil. And what is recommended is that this soil should be a little moist but not wet. So this is the kind of soil that you can use for testing. They also recommend that you leave the soil overnight and then begin your test. So let's start with the first test. The first test is one of the most important tests, called the pH test, which basically measures how acidic or alkaline your soil is. Now, why do we need to do that? Well, for plants to absorb nutrients from the soil needs to have the correct pH. So for example, most of the vegetables thrive when the pH of the soil is between the numbers 6 and 7. Now I'll shortly explain you what those numbers are, because you really need to have a test card or a reference card to see those numbers. So to do the pH test, you add one test tablet of the pH test into the testing tube, and then you add a little bit of the soil sample to it. Now when you're choosing the soil, or when you're adding the soil, just make sure you don't add any wood chips or large particles. If you wish, you could sift the soil, which means that you remove the large particles and only use the fine particles. And it's also recommended that you use distilled water, or at least filtered water, so that the test results are accurate. Tap water contains a lot of added salts, which might give you a false result. Now, once you shake the solution very well with the soil, you let it stand for a few seconds, about 30 seconds to a minute. And once the soil settles down, you need to match the color of the solution on the top with the pH level. So as you can see here, the pH level is a little bit towards 6, as you saw in the picture. Now let's take a soil sample from another bed. And remember that if you have multiple areas in your garden, you need to do one test per area. And let's wait for this solution to settle down. It usually takes about a minute for the soil to settle down. And here you can see when we measure the pH level, it's about 7, which is again ideal. So as long as your pH is between 6 and 7, you're good. However, some plants do like higher or lower pH. Now, changing soil pH is very easy. You add garden lime to make the soil more alkaline and sulfur to make the soil more acidic. Now remember that some plants do prefer acidic soil, like blueberries, so be careful what you're doing. So let's now jump to the nutrients test. The first nutrient we will test is nitrogen. For preparing the test solution, dissolve 2 Floc-Ex tablets in the water and then add the soil. The Floc-Ex tablets let the soil settle down towards the bottom of the cup so that you can use the clear solution that's on the top to do all the tests. So once you dissolve the two tablets and the soil settles down, you will be using this solution for the rest of your nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium tests. We will now add the nitrate test tablet to the testing tube. Now the solution that we created earlier will be used for all the three tests. So make sure you save the water from the previous test. So as you can see here, we need to reach the mark that is there in the tube. And once that mark is reached, just make sure that you have just enough water, and then make sure the solution is really well mixed. And once this settles down, you can measure the level of nitrogen. And as you can see here, it's very low. It really matches the low nitrogen level. And this is a very true indication of the nitrogen levels, because most California soils, for example, are deficient in nitrogen. So you need to make sure that you have adequate nitrogen in the soil. So as you can see here, these are the ways to add nitrogen to your soil, and your plants will really benefit from that. Some of these are organic sources and some of these are inorganic sources. And whether you want to use organic or inorganic fertilizers really depends on your choice. The plants do not distinguish between either fertilizer types. So the next important nutrient that plants need is phosphorus. Now let's go ahead and do the phosphorus test in a similar manner. And then you can see here the chart now corresponds to phosphorus that's quite high. So our soil is really not deficient in phosphorus in this case. And remember that you need to test soil from various locations in your garden to arrive at any conclusion. Now if you do find your soil deficient in phosphorus, which is essential for flowering and producing bulbs, you need to make sure that you either add bone meal, manure, rock phosphate, or superphosphate. Once again, whether you use organic sources or not is entirely up to you. You are the best judge. And the final nutrient that plants need is potassium. And in this test, you can see that the level of potassium in our soil matches high, which means that we have adequate potassium levels. Now note that most soils will have a lot of potassium and phosphorus. It's nitrogen that most of the soils lack, because plants use a lot of nitrogen when they grow. So with this soil test, you can really make sure that your soil has adequate potassium, which is really good for growing plants that produce a lot of roots and tubers. And here are the common sources of potassium that you can add to your soil. Again, some of these are organic sources, some of them are inorganic sources, and both of them work really well for growing your plants in your garden. So there we have it. That's our soil test results. And I hope you liked this video, and I hope this encourages you to do a soil test. If you're not getting success in your garden, and especially if you're growing in the ground, it does make a lot of sense to do a soil test to make sure that you're growing your plants in the most optimum conditions. Now, if you're growing in containers, you can still do this test and add amendments to your container soil. But in any case, doing a soil test really helps you understand your soil. And in my case, for example, most of the soil in my garden was deficient in nitrogen. So I knew that I had to really add a lot of nitrogen sources to my soil, which meant adding a lot of manure, compost, and some nitrogen fertilizers. So that was our video on the soil test. And do let me know, what do you think about this? Do you do a soil test for your garden, or do you just add a lot of organic material and give it a best shot? Do let me know. I'll see you again soon. Happy gardening.